В этом году в Турции, на чемпионате Европы, именно на этой дисциплине, бешеной эстафете, команда в составе Алены Трапезниковой и Сергея Горланова стала чемпионом Европы, и сегодня они в чемпионском титуле.
This is the biathlon arena in Khantymansinsk in Russia, and you're very welcome to the European Ski Orienteering Championships and the World Cup final. We're about to have the sprint relay today. The arena is bathing in sun today. There were some snowfall yesterday, and my name is Per Frost. I'm joined here in the commentary booth by Øyvind Vatterdal. What can we say about the conditions for the sprint relay today?
Yeah, as we see, the temperature is plus 3 degrees and it's sunny, so the sun will definitely affect the snow. But I think the waxers have done a great job this morning, and hopefully there won't be decided on the skis, and we have some interesting route choices and competition.
Yes, so we're in the city of Khantymansinsk by the bank of the Irtush River, around the 300 kilometers east of Moscow, well known for winter sports, especially for biathlon. They hosted the World Championships in 2011, for example, and it is those tracks that we are using partly, at least. Sprint relay, there are two members in each team, one woman and one man, and this is one of the favorites, Sergei Goranov from Russia, we saw there. So we can explain how the sprint relay works.
Yeah, as you said, the team consists of two person. It's a mixed sprint relay, so you have one woman and one man. They each ski three times, so six legs in total. And the legs are forked, as the mass start middle distance yesterday. So there might be some small changes, some small differences in the forkings, but the last part of the men's last leg will be unforked, so then we'll know for sure.
So we'll have a look at the map. The beginning here starts out from the arena. Everyone has to ski up the hill on a very wide track, then it's forked, and second one is a common control. We will see them on camera there. So on fourth and on sixth, and there are forked controls in between. Why they changed the layout here on the GPS preview is that the last leg is straight, or the last part of the last leg is straight, at least. There were a mistake there, but exactly. Sprint relay, the course is about 2 kilometers with 9 controls, and it's not that much of climbing as it was the other days. So yeah, these are the World Cup standings for teams right now. There has been one relay. It was not the sprint relay, but another relay. And Russia is leading ahead of Sweden right now.
Yeah, the start list. Russia has start number one because they won last year the European Championships in Turkey. And I think we have to say that they're big favorites today as well.
Russia has Alyona Trapechnikova on first, and then Sergei Gorlanov. Both won gold medals at the sprint competition. Then following teams are, for instance, we have Sweden with Magdalena Olsson, and we have Marcus Lundholm. As we said, we keep Russians as the favorites. Of course, it's a relay with six legs. Everything can happen. Finland is also in the fight for a very good position. We also count in Czech Republic and Estonia, for instance, fighting for the medals here.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see what Estonia can do with two skiers showing a lot of improvement.
So they get to see the map 15 seconds ahead, and then it's off on the start for the first leg, women racing. And you can see there are many teams, more teams than there are nations here, and that's because some of the nations have more than one team. For instance, Russia have 5 teams competing today.
Yeah, we're competing in on home soil, so Russia can have a national group, so they have a few extra teams.
So first, just cross-country skiing up the biathlon track here.
Estonia is taking the lead on the right.
Yes, Daisa Kudre, who took an impressive bronze medal yesterday. We can also see that yesterday's winner, Tatiana Oborina, she's not even in the first team for Russia, even though she took the gold medal yesterday. She's in the second team. And that's, of course, also one of the favorite teams today.
Someone tripped over, but it was Russia's third team, Vyatkina.
If we will be able to see, maybe see a replay of that. So now they are off on the first controls, which are forked. And then on the second control again, we will see them gathered, because that's a common control. So it would be, of course, too much to say that it would be an easy win for Russia, because it won't. They will have to, or they are favorites, but yeah, what can we say about the expectations now? We don't know anything about how the race developed yet.
No, but as we saw from the map, the controls are really close to each other, and you can easily miss punch or take a control in the wrong direction.
And here you can see there are 3 different controls. Russia and Norway has the same in the beginning, and Estonia is pushing very hard right now.
And so yeah.
You can't really say it's a gap because the tail here is only 10 seconds, but she is at least ahead of the other ones.
And she has the longest forking on this first control.
As we saw yesterday, it might be an advantage. Oh, now it's the second control here, and Sweden and Norway, or is it Norway that's in the lead? It's Norway,
yeah.
Norway team 3, actually. And also the Russian first team is up there, and Russian number 3, a bunch of teams. So Sweden and Estonia, Norway and the Russian first team, and then all the other comes just a few seconds behind. But
it's really tight here right now. And
but a strong start from Estonia, we could say. She have the longer forking here.
But yeah, as we expected, it's no surprise. So
are there any teams that we should have expected? Czech Republic is 10 seconds behind, but it's still it stops up here when they have to go into the narrow track. And this is actually one of the first time as we see the narrow tracks on the TV cameras as well, which is the main part of the skiing, the ski orienteering.
Yeah, especially in this race, because there's a lot, it's a very dense network and a lot of controls.
So the narrow tracks, they're around 1.5 meter wide, maybe 1 meter.
Yes. Now we see Sweden's reaching the third control.
Yes, and now on this leg they have from control 2 and into the finish there are only 2 forking different forking controls. But on the last leg everyone will have this control straight. So the 6th control, and Estonia's in the lead ahead of Russia's first team, and then Sweden. Then there is a gap down to 2 Finnish teams. The first team first there, and the second team, and the others coming. And the Czech Republic. And why we try to mention all the national teams, that's because for the European Championships, only the first finishing team from each nation counts. So it might be so that there are two teams or even three teams from one country that arrives on the three first positions, but then the next nation finishing will get the next medal.
Exactly, so there's no point of giving up.
And it's actually not too unusual that the second team gets a medal either on this championship. So everyone has something to fight for. And look at Estonia. It's a gap down to Sweden and to Russia. 6 seconds right now to Sweden and 9 to Russia. And Sweden 2, Isabel Salén, and Finland's first team with Mario Turunen. Here comes Tatjana Borina.
Russia 2. Russia has at least three strong teams, so you won't be surprised if they had two teams on the podium.
We have had two teams now from Czech Republic and Kazakhstan as well. So they are at least top 10 in the European Championships right now. Or sorry, I have to double check if Kazakhstan counts as a European team.
I don't think so.
No, it belongs to Asia.
Eurasia.
So soon, time for the eighth control here and for a changeover. The first changeover, then Russia is in the lead. So something happened with Estonia, maybe just a longer forking. So it's still Russia, Estonia, Sweden when they go down this hill into the arena.
Russia had a shorter forking on the previous control, so that's why.
And now their teammate is waiting on the middle of the arena, so they will have they will change over. The teammate will have to pick up his map.
Sergei Gulanov is going to change with Trapesnikov.
Matis Yama with Daisy Kudre. And we could say that Kudre is, from our expectations, the strongest one in the Estonian team. But Matis Yama, he surprised yesterday.
Yeah, he showed good performance, even though he was really tired. But
he was in a good position all the way through the middle distance race. And especially with a strong start. So Russia is first, and Sweden, Estonia is together.
Marcus Lundholm is changing with Magdalena Olsson.
Marcus Lundholm is seemed to be strong this championship. He took the bronze medal yesterday on the middle distance. And also Czech Republic made a good leg. They're only 15 seconds behind Russia right now.
Yeah, it's not separating many seconds between the first teams. And it might be a few seconds difference between the forking, so here it's wide open yet.
Yeah, and Golanov have already managed to get the map into the map board, and he is setting off onto his track. So Russia, Sweden, Estonia right now on the medal positions. Then comes Finland and Czech Republic. And more teams are dropping in, but it shouldn't last too many seconds until we have the first skiers on the first TV control, which is the second control on their course. So up this hill, it's Sweden, Estonia. Here comes also Finland. And this is the Swedish second team with Erik Rost, who actually took the silver medal 1 year ago, but now he didn't make it to the sprint relay team.
No, he has many medals with Tove Alexandersson, but this time he was put on the second team.
We're following the Finnish second team there, as Golanov heads into the second control.
Still in the lead, but
the other ones can also see him all the time. Yeah. He has to take one more control before he gets there. And so does the other. So they had it's Estonia who have this little bit longer forking, or at least the A control, which is more to ski on the wide tracks before you reach the second control.
Sweden first team has a long forking now, but Sergey Gulanov is already on the way to the team.
Yeah, and it seems the same tendency as we saw yesterday. He sets off in a tremendous pace. And the question is, will anyone be able to catch him up from now? Erik Ross from Sweden's second team is the next one here, and now Finland is on bronze position, Estonia and the Swedish first team. And Jakob Skoda and Ville Petrisarila, they take the time to read the map quite carefully down this slope.
Yeah, it's really short legs and it's really hectic, so it's very important to make the right route choices all the time.
And the World Cup leader before this championship, Andrei Lamov, didn't either make it to the first
the team. Third team.
He's actually on Russia team three, but so is also Marina Vyatkina, silver medalist.
And that tells so much about the strong Russian athletes.
And she was also on the podium for the sprint, on bronze position there. So Russia now has a lead of more than 10 seconds. And the Norwegian teams make some last minute preparations of the skis. What do they do now?
Looked like they were doing some hand grinding. Probably they were told by the athlete that the snow was pretty wet in the forest. And they gave some feedback on that.
And Estonia is ahead of Finland now, but only some 6 seconds. And here comes
Jakob Skoda.
Jakob Skoda. So. It means that Czech Republic and Finland and Estonia are fighting for the bronze medal.
We still have 9 teams within 30 seconds, so it's still...
Yeah, it's still... It feels so secure when you see Sergey Golanov and Aliona Trepechkova racing, but we know that things can happen and we have to be aware of that. Sweden team 2 with Erik Rost and Estonia with Matis Jama.
Yeah.
And I think it's interesting to see that almost every time we see them, they are reading the map. So we're following Golanov into one of the narrow tracks here.
You can see the forest is really dense as well.
Yeah, it's no room for any shortcuts through the forest.
So you see, Russia had a short forking here, so that's why it's pulling a little bit away.
Yeah. Could we see something else than Sweden and Finland won, and they are changing position with each other? Sweden first team there. Okay, Golanov already into the changeover. The camera turns around with him, which probably means that the other ones are not at control number 8 yet, and he is pushing hard.
He's pushing really hard here.
It's quite steep downhill.
Yeah, it's just downhill here to the finish, so there's no point of saving. Oh, doing some shortcuts.
Yeah, the option here is to either take 2 meters extra and stop, or to just go through the deep snow there. Golanov is already on the shooting range, while the other ones are going down the downhill. So Russia will have, in this competition, big lead. Aliona Trepechnikova, the sprint European champion, and And Estonia, Daisy Kudre is getting ready, and so are Isabel Salén and Magdalena Olsson. And Marjut Turunen from Finland. Sweden team 2 and Estonia right now on the medal positions. But then it's 2 seconds down to Finland, so nothing is decided. And a few seconds more, 16 seconds more down to Czech Republic. And lots of Russian teams, we can say that. Russian teams with medalists actually in all of them, medalists from this week. And we are on the third competition day.
But you have 6 teams that has pulled a little bit away from the others, but we'll see if some of the other Russian teams can keep up.
And, might be a little bit frustrating to meet Trapechnikova when going downhill here, knowing that she has already been out for
more than a minute. Yeah, but I think the teams that are going down to the stadium now, they're out of the position for a good spot.
Okay, so 25 seconds lead for Russia right now. Is it already decided?
It's not decided, not for sure, but it looks promising for Russia, and it's no surprise that they have a clear lead. We expected them to be the big favorites.
Leona Trepechnikova and Sergei Gorlanov, they are the reigning European champions from the sprint relay in Turkey 1 year ago, and it seems promising for them as well. Trepechnikova has the B forking here. Kudra has the A forking, and Sweden also has B and C there.
B is perhaps the shortest forking here as well, so they won't catch any time on Russia here.
But it means that Russia will, or maybe have had the longest forking, but they will have a slightly longer on the next time, as Trepechnikova is going here on her last leg. You can see that Turunen is heading into the forest in the same time as Trepechnikova is already on at control number 2. Takes her time to read the map down while skiing, of course, and by takes the time, I mean she takes around 5 seconds to read the map. Not too much. But still enough for her to make a decision to go turn right into this narrow track immediately. And Estonia right now on second position, and looks really good for Estonia right now, and also for Finland.
Yeah, you see now Sweden first team is not in the picture, so they have probably had a long forking.
Sweden, the Swedish first team is here, and second team there. So, but there is some seconds between Turunen and Olsson there. And here is Sweden team 3 as well, and Russia team 2. So looks promising for Russia, we can say so, but it's a really tough fight between for the other medals.
Yeah, it is. Sweden, Estonia and Finland are definitely in.
This was already on control number 4. So it gets tough now for the TV director to be able to follow the competition, as she might be one common control ahead of the other ones. It seems like Estonia is actually getting a few meters there.
Yeah. Sweden and Finland is together.
Of course, Magdalena Olsson always have the back of Daisy Kudrja.
They're right in their tail, so
yeah.
They're all a big group now.
Estonia, Sweden right now, and Finland only three or four seconds behind. So at this point it seemed like the main task for Gorlanov and Trapetsnikova right now is to not make mistakes.
Yeah, but I don't think Gorlanov is going to save anything. He's going to push all the way until the last loop where he knows he has the victory for sure.
And all the teams together there, they have the same forking. It seems like they take a safe route choice.
Yeah. To ski around on the wide track is always a safe choice.
Magdalena Olsson is...
She has passed Estonia.
She's passed Estonia and...
Daisy looking a little bit tired
she
right now.
She looks a little bit tired. She is skiing on the...
Well, luckily for her, it's mostly downhill from here to the stadium.
Yeah, she's skiing with the skating technique, mostly used for tougher, for steeper uphills than Olsson is doing, for instance. But so does also Viatkina. She might seem a little bit tired as well. Yes, lost that connection now. Changeover for Gorlanov once again. It's Vladislav Kiselov with
the Russian second team.
Yeah, so he was silver medalist in the sprint, which means that he will be in the second team. And now Sweden is alone.
Yeah, she got some meters here.
But so is also Estonia. There's no one behind.
Yeah, the guy behind her was on a different leg.
Yeah, it was Slovenia on a different leg. So Sergei Gorlanov sets off.
And quite a big lead now.
They have quite a big lead, but the gap for Sweden down to Estonia is also quite big right now. So,
7 seconds down,
seven
to,
seconds down to Estonia, yeah. And then we know that Estonia's fastest skier might be Kudrja, so...
But Finland has yet to come, so...
Finland is not there yet.
Passing there.
And then Finland can also go with the other second and third teams from Russia and Sweden.
Yeah, but Estonia has 20 seconds on Finland now, so they have a good chance for the medal.
Estonia indeed has a good chance for the medal, and it seems promising for them. And I believe it's their most successful international championship, maybe ever, for Estonia.
Yeah, we mentioned them as one of the potential medal winners before the race, so it's no surprise. But one thing is to be among the top favorites, another thing is to actually take a medal.
Yeah, if you compare, for instance, with... of course, Finland is always a favorite for the medals, but it seems like their neighbor country, Estonia, they are actually slightly faster all the time today when we see them on the course. So So it's all about not making any mistakes from Sergei Golanov now. We have, but we have seen that he's very stable. The same applies, of course, for Marcus Lundholm and for Mattis Jama. So Russia is already almost at the second control. But what happens behind? It seems like Estonia is going into the wrong forking, actually. Yeah. He follows the pack, and that is wrong. He goes through wrong control.
Looks like he's stopping now. He's confused.
Yeah, I think he believed that he was one crossing ahead.
Yeah, that's a possible.
And then it's wide open again. So we see that Jama turns into the forest there on the control, which Lundholm already visited the first control. So suddenly Estonia, they doesn't have that good chance anyway.
Yeah, you anymore. Have to stay focused all the time, and you can't afford mistakes like that.
And it was maybe 3 seconds of missing concentration there.
Yeah, we've been commentating how they read the map this downhill all the time, and Mattis Jama probably, yeah, here he comes.
So right now, Finland is on the bronze position, and Estonia some seconds behind, but that's of course...
But it's not over yet. He's no. Only 4 seconds behind Finland.
He's only 4 seconds behind Finland, but what impact does that make on your mental skills?
Yeah, you don't get a good feeling, and it's very easy to do new mistakes in the future of the race.
And now we are following only Estonia here. Yeah, of course, we can see his mistake. He went to the control A1, but he was supposed to go to control B1. And I guess he's not making any mistakes now, but that was, should we say, disastrous for Estonia. They were in such a good position there.
Yeah, but as you see, the areas are really similar. There's a wide track going to the right at both places. Yeah,
it's really easy then to make a parallel mistake, and then it takes some time to also understand what mistake you've done. So Kiselov and Erik Rost, they are in the fight for the competition, of course, but not for European Championships medals. That's why we are focusing so much on Estonia and Finland here. Finland, Swedish third team, and Estonia, they're reading the map carefully now, especially Estonia, I guess.
Yeah. He has caught up. He's still 4 seconds behind Finland, only 2 seconds behind Sweden's third team.
But Andrei Lamov looks, I would say he looks tired.
He has been a little bit sick with the cold, so he's not in shape of his life.
This is Marcus Lundholm from Sweden now, in a very good position for a silver medal. But behind comes Sweden 2 and Russia 2. Which of course is a good motivation, but it doesn't make much for the European Championships. But the fight of the bronze right now between Finland and Estonia.
Yeah, Sweden has a good grip on the silver now, so it's a big fight about the bronze.
Yeah, but so had Estonia before this leg. This is Japan early leg, and they unfortunately also broken a pole. So Andrei Lamov, Russia 3. And here is another Finnish team.
Ville Petrisalo.
It's Finland number second team, yes. And here comes Norway. We thought they should be in the fight for a medal as well, but they're too far behind.
yeah, they've never really been into the fight about the medals. And
you see, it's all already changeover for the last leg for Trapeznikova. So, just about not making mistakes.
Yeah, nothing is decided. She can't afford a mistake like Matsuyama did. Or actually, she can afford it.
She can afford it if she's strong in a sprint. But let's say
she has 42 seconds, so she can make a small mistake. But
yeah, she made a quite huge mistake yesterday, actually, on the middle distance.
Yeah.
So we'll see. Sweden and Russia are following. So Sweden right now in a good position for a silver. But what about Finland and what about Estonia?
Yeah, now Estonia has passed Finland, actually.
Yeah, they are together into the changeover. So this will be exciting. The fight of the bronze. Will it be Estonia or will it be Finland? I think Estonians, I think they are very motivated right now.
I can't recall they've ever taken a medal in relay.
No, so Finland is one of the countries with the longest tradition of ski orienteering. And it's also the neighbor of Estonia with a quite small ski orienteering community.
And we can say that Estonia is supposed to organize the World Championships next year.
They are. And probably with a lot of help from Daisy Kudre, for instance. Then. So Estonia and Finland now together out on the last leg for the women. This will be exciting to see. And nobody has any time for mistakes. Trapeznikova can make 20 seconds, but not more than that. She seems confident. So Sweden should have the forking A and Estonia B, Finland A. So they can't trust each other at all.
No, as we know, the C forking is slightly longer, but the A and B forking doesn't separate much.
And Trapeznikova go out on take, gets a lot of very wide track on the way to the second control. And we should look so that.
Oi, here she misses the punch.
Oh! And that is how much? 10 seconds. But it was bright of her to recognize it.
Yeah, she didn't lose much, 5-10 seconds, so.
Yeah, but this the ship that they're carrying on the arm, it should start to flash and beep a little bit. Okay, so Estonia right now, they have the B, and Finland gets the A, but we know it's a bit to go to this control. So Sweden in a safe second position right now. It's more about if it should be Swedish first or second team that should be able to go up to the podium.
Oh!
Oh! It seems to be a problem with that.
Has fallen down on the ground.
With the punching device there. Okay, so actually, it's also a fight for the medal between the Swedish teams right now.
Absolutely.
And
as you see.
And Estonia and Finland, they are together and
they're all missing the punch.
Daisy Kudre were lucky enough to take this. So we're waiting for more teams, but of course also Trapeznikov already to the next control.
Appears that the left control is not working, but everyone has to punch on both controls.
So looks good for Estonia right now.
Yeah, they have a few meters on Finland.
Sweden, Magdalena Olsson is
still ahead of Sweden's second team. Here comes Estonia.
Finland is on a very good bronze position once again. Turunen is, of course, extremely motivated to catch that medal as well. She was a little bit unfortunate with the punching on the second control there. And it was a sixth control that we saw Trapeznikova passing. And we should mention that once again that the course is completely straight now. There are no forkings.
You see, there are two different route choices here. Estonia and Finland doing the same.
Between the four
right.
And five, yes. And hard to decide which is the fastest. One might be a little bit more. The one that Estonia took is some more climbing. And now Swedish second team is in the silver position. So it will be interesting to see if Erik Rost or Marcus Lundholm on the last leg will be able to take the silver medal here. And it will also be extremely interesting to see if Mattis Jama will be able to keep away from Thomas Kotro.
Yeah, Thomas Kotter was third on the sprint, so he is really strong and he's probably motivated when he see he has a chance for a bronze medal.
And you saw the name, maybe Doris Kotter there. It's something wrong. It's Daisy Kotter. It's Doris is her sister, who is not racing today. She's also in the Estonian national team. The last change over now for the home nation. And Trapeznikova takes it. Takes time to check that she gets the punch on all the control, which is, of course, extremely important. So, Sergei Gorlanov. And we'll see. You thought that he won't save any energy, and I don't think so either. But who will be in the fight for the silver? This is Tatiana Oborina and Magdalena Olsson. We didn't see if Salén passed before there. Doesn't seem like that. No,
she's
already there. So Sweden team two right now on the silver medal position. And the second Swedish team, Erik Rost, he was let me just check, but I think he was fourth yesterday.
Yeah, but he has done many sprint relays before and have many medals together with Tuva Alexandrov. So he knows what he's doing and what he has to do.
About the bronze medal, now Estonia has a gap down to Finland. Daisy Kudre shouting something to her teammate Mattis Jama, and he has never went out in a relay in this position before.
No, and he knows that for sure, and that's probably why he made a mistake in the previous leg, because they know they are in a good position, and they only have 5 seconds now, so there's no room for any mistakes like that again.
It will be very interesting to see if he will manage to keep calm and do the orienteering and also ski faster than Tuomas Koutru, who has a bronze medal for the sprint. So yeah. Russia right now in the lead ahead of Sweden, number two. Sweden 1, Russia 2, and Estonia on bronze position right now, but only some few seconds down to Finland. And Sergei Gorlanov, he didn't save any energy out of the stadium. It must be also be nice for Aliona Trepechnikova to make such a stable performance today. Maybe he saw on the big screen on the arena that one of the devices are not working.
Yeah, you saw he punching on the left control, so either someone told him or he saw it on the screen, yeah.
And from the second control, as for the women, the men have no forkings, so these are the last forkings for today. Sweden have B and Estonia have C, Finland have C as well. But I don't think they will. I don't think Yama will trust anyone anymore today.
It looks like Finland had passed Estonia now.
Yeah, it looks so. And we know for sure that Tuomas Koutru is a very strong skier.
Indeed.
So Ekros did a quick map reading. Lundholm took some more time to watch the map.
And it's a strong fight among the silver medal within the Swedish team.
Yeah, and I don't think any one of them will just give away the medal to one of the other ones.
No, it's prestigious to be the best team.
And you will get the medal.
of course. Yeah, because when you lose that fight, this battle, you end up with nothing.
Yeah. And maybe most exciting fight of today, the one about the bronze. Let's see, will they still be together, or will actually Finland be able to gain some meters on Estonia here? I believe they actually passed the second control without letting us see them. So did Russia on control number four.
There's not much route choices where they can make a different route choice either to try to win some terrain.
So Sweden 2, Sweden 1 are still skiing together. And now it's a route choice to the fifth control here. So we'll see if they take the same. Finland, Estonia is following closely behind Finland. It might be about their sprinting capacity later on.
They will both take the left here now, the two Swedish team, I'm pretty sure.
So Gorlanov still, it's just about seeing how much time it will be. But here is Estonia, here is Finland.
They're right together.
Back. Oh. What's happening? Okay, they don't lose time against each other, but it's like they were not really confident about the map reading here.
No, and you saw Matis Jama in the back. He was not prepared when Tuomas Koutru didn't know where to go. So,
if he had been prepared, he should have just approached.
He could have just taken the chance and passed right away.
Got some meters, yeah. So it will still be a fight between Estonia and Finland. Sweden 2, Sweden 1, fight for the silver medal. So the silver medal will most probably go to Sweden, but it's not decided of which team. Either Magdalena Olsson and Marcus Lundholm or Isabel Salén and Erik Rost.
Yeah, I'm not sure who has the strongest finish amongst
those
two.
Look at Estonia and Finland now. They are taking different route choices.
Oy, oy, oy.
Maybe it's the... of course, it's the only chance if you want to decide it before the finish. And let's see when they show up on the next camera control, if we'll get to see that. Of course, Russia is going into the arena already now, and they will be the European champions. And I hope we'll be able to get them into finish and at the same time also see what happens behind there.
Yeah, Russia didn't make it exciting today, but we have a really interesting fights about
I can tell you we have an interesting fight. Here is Sweden, and Erik just has a few meters, but will Lundholm be able to sprint faster? We will see.
I don't know their sprinting capability, so but it's a long sprint here at the stadium.
This is Kravchenko on another leg. But Gorlanov heading into finish, and I can actually say that I think it's decided about the bronze, but we'll see if...
Someone who doesn't have to sprint is Sergei Gorlanov and Trapesnikova.
Oh, such impressive performance by them.
And they win again.
So they won last year, they will win again. Or they won again.
And they will probably win again in the future someday.
Impressive, yes. And fight for the silver and bronze medals then.
Let's see if we have some pictures.
But I would say that first we take the... it's the Swedish first team.
Lundholm has a big gap.
So Sweden's first team takes the silver medal. Silver to Sweden, and I can tell you it's decided also about the bronze medal. Let's just wait until we see them. So Marcus Lundholm, Magdalena Olsson, they take the silver medal. And please let us see the fight for the bronze now. You can see one skier, but that's Kiselov.
Here we have them.
Here we have them, and you see Estonia will take the bronze medal. Estonia will take the bronze medal today.
Russia's second team is passing the finish line before them, but Estonia is taking the bronze medal. Daisy Kudra is waiting in the finish area.
And this is, of course, a big day for Estonian skier in Tiering. They take the bronze medal ahead of Finland. It's their second medal in these championships, and it's a huge performance by the Estonian team.
Yeah, but it's no surprise we mentioned them as a big favorite. Oh!
It's so... Linus Rapp and Andriy Lamov, they are also normally competing for the same
I think Linus
the same
Rapp
club.
Look frustrated here.
Yeah.
Have to see the replay, but I think Andriy Lamov was maybe pushing a little bit in the corner.
Maybe they were both pushing a little bit. We'll have to see that.
It's Norway first team.
Yes, and... let's see this.
It was too late to see.
Too late to see. Lamo were trying to pass Linus Rapp, and then seems like took a step out. Things that happens when it's a tough fight on the finish. Okay, between Norway and Czech Republic here.
Jørgen Baklid on the second Norwegian team, and there are not many who beats him in a sprint finish.
And he is completely exhausted, and so are Jakob Skoda. Didn't look too.
Yeah, we have new sprints together.
Norway again and Finland.
Yeah. Lars Moholt is also a very good sprinter, so I have a chance that he will take this if he wants, of course. They're looking each other.
Ah. If you come into the finish lane together with another, of course you want to take it. He looks quite calm, actually, yeah, when he takes this.
He has done many last legs in the men's relay and won many battles before.
So we saw a very fast race. It was really not any question about the victory today. Russia were so much stronger than the other ones.
They were, as expected, but among the other teams, other medals, we have had a very interesting competition, I think.
Very interesting indeed, and fights both for the silver medal and for the bronze medal. And I actually think we have three very happy medalist teams today. Russia won, Sweden won, and Estonia.
Yeah, for Russia, only gold is good enough. And
Exactly. So they're happy with the gold. And Sweden made a great performance as well, and so did Estonia. So one more of the Russian teams finishing. There were five of them, actually. No, there were eight of the Russian teams. But the winners were the first team, Sergei Gorodanov and Alyona Trapechnikova. They could pass the finish line together with well enough time. And this is a replay of the last leg. You see, Russia was already in a huge lead. And maybe the most interesting here is to, of course, Russia too made a good race as well, but Finland and Estonia, the fight between the two nations, and also, yeah, Sweden 1 and Sweden 2, but they were skiing mostly together. So at this point, Finland is ahead of Estonia.
Yeah, but they're right next to each other.
They're right next to each other. We saw they were right next to each other also on control number 4, where they hesitated a little bit. Maybe a little bit unnecessarily, actually. You see, they stop here. But Russia is so far ahead now.
Both Swedish teams turns back in the fifth control.
And here is a route choice once again, and this is where Estonia secures the bronze medal.
Yeah.
So he is around 7 seconds ahead of Finland at this point, and then even though Thomas Kotter is a strong skier, he didn't manage to catch up with Matti Siama.
No, and there's still orienteering left after the sixth control, so it's very good job with Matti Siama to keep his head cold and keep the gap he had to Finland.
And a very strong finish also by Marcus Lundholm there, fighting, sprinting down Erik Rost actually on the stadium. So Russia wins ahead of Sweden 1, Sweden 2, and Russia 2, and then the bronze medal goes to Estonia in this European Ski Orienteering Championships and the World Cup final of sprint relay of 2020 in Khantamashinsk here in Russia. So we So this is the list of the race today, and we will also try to conclude the European Championships. We will have to take away the second Sweden, Russian, Finland team to be able to do that. But this is a recap of the race. So the women skied the legs 1, 3 and 5. And the first team from Sweden, they were not in the second position all the time, but they managed to be so in the end. With Magdalena Olsson and Marcus Lundholm, and a tough fight for Estonia first here, and then Finland, but Erik Rost and Isabel Salén, they were also in the fight for the silver medal until the very last meters of the course, actually. Erik Rost not too happy with that. But today, the team of the Russian Federation, they were simply much stronger than anyone else. So Aliona Trapechnikova made secure races, and Sergei Gorlanov could take them into the gold medal position. And that concludes the European Ski Orienteering Championship sprint relay here in Khantamashinsk, and these are the nation results. Russia, Sweden, Estonia takes medals, Finland, Norway, Czech Republic takes the following places. Austria, Switzerland won't be counted because it's a combination team, and Kazakhstan, they are from Asia, so they're not counted into the European Championships either. So, any last words, Eivind, from the sprint relay?
No, it was a super interesting day. It was quite different from yesterday. We saw there was very tight between the teams, and in the end, Russia won as we expected. But we had a good show about the silver and bronze medal.
So that was the sprint relay. My name is Per Frost. I was joined by Eivind Vatterdal. Tomorrow there won't be any competition. It will be a rest day. But on Saturday, we're back again with the long distance from Khantamashinsk. So thank you for today.